Welcome back, everybody. The aviation world has been rocked, as you guys know, by the worldwide grounding of those Boeing 737 MAX jets. And it's caused all sorts of problems for travelers. Here with his travel tips and how to avoid certain types of planes, give it up for the Thrifty Traveler, our buddy Jared Kamrowski, everybody. Hello.
Thanks for having me again, Jason.
Okay, what do we need to know that we don't know already about the 737s as consumers, as just everyday people?
Sure. So there's a lot of the issues with the 737 MAX. With aviation disasters, there's never one problem.
Yeah.
It's a compounding set of issues. It's very complicated. And right now, all the 737 MAXs are grounded.
What does that mean for, especially for MSP? Is it a big problem for us at MSP?
So there are several, like Icelandair flies nonstop to Reykjavik. Probably the most likely one that you'd fly in, and the only airline that I've flown 737 MAX on was Southwest.
Okay.
And when you're flying Southwest, you know, you normally would have no idea that you're flying a 737 MAX because it looks just like any other aircraft.
Okay, that brings me to one of our main topics. So I always call our normal viewer, Betty from Anoka. Betty from Anoka is watching this, and she's like, well, Jared, how in the world do I know what plane I'm flying? I can barely book my own ticket, let alone. So what do you say?
You know, overall, don't even worry about it because it's not going to be an issue. You know, the government's currently looking at, you know, what are the issues? The investigations are ongoing.
Yeah.
You know, some politicians are asking for, you know, crazy things like going back to the Flintstones stage of aviation where, you know, planes aren't as fancy, and it's crazy. So it's a lot of blowback. There's a lot of stuff in the news. There's the all, you know, Betty from Anoka, just book the ticket.
But is there any advantage to knowing the type of plane you're on?
Sure.
Is there?
Yeah, well, absolutely. So when I did fly the 737 MAX on Southwest, it is a beautiful, nice new aircraft. And once they resolve the issues with it, it's going to be something you want to fly on.
Okay.
So what you want to do when you do book the ticket, when you go to checkout, usually you can see which aircraft you're going to be on. And a good thing, and also to know your seats, which is a thing we've talked about, because you're going to have typically newer, better seats, sometimes more legroom on newer aircraft. So you can always go to seatguru.com and you can look at what your legroom is.
Again, write that down, everybody. It's a great, we use it all the time, seatguru.com. Okay, Mr. Fancy. now people are they're going to lose their mind. You just got back. Well, you tell everyone where you just got an unbelievable trip for an unbelievable price.
Right. So I flew first class to Tokyo, Japan, which is a 14-hour-ish flight from Chicago. And it was on ANA, which is one of the carriers of Japan. It was a $22,000 flight that I was able to book with points and miles for $300. So, yeah, it's pretty incredible. Lay flat seat, caviar, champagne. There's no showers.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
pretty wild.
Guys, again, $22,000 for $300. And Jared and I are friends, and we're friends on Instagram. I saw that pic. I was sitting at home, like, in my pajamas. And I said, I hate you right now. You're sitting there. Then you put on your pajamas, your fancy pajamas, and like, for $22,000, they better give you like a kid. You know what I mean? Yeah. What was it like, though? What was that? Was it nice?
It's great. You know, I'm not a one percenter like you, Jason.
Oh,
so
whatever.
I don't have the limousines. I don't have those private jets.
Don't you laugh at that. No.
No, I'm just kidding. But, you know, none of us, you know, most of us just want to go to Chicago for free. But, you know, if you can have that chance to do, you know, first class travel for $300, there's a nerdy world of points and miles and travel hacking out there that I'm, of course, really into.
Yeah.
That's super cool.
Speaking of points, and at the end of the show, by the way, Jared's going to stick around, and I will tell you once again, I always do a big trip in July, you know, when the show goes, I do a two-week break. Once again, I will tell you the trip we're doing and how, because of Jared, I paid for basically 1.5 flights, and that's coming up in the show. But playing the points game, correct me if I'm wrong, you just went to an all-inclusive, and you used points.
Yes.
How did you do that?
This is super attainable. Betty from Anoka, you can book this. There's Hyatt all-inclusive properties in the Caribbean and Mexico. And I know going to a beach destination isn't for everybody. But, you know, flying to Mexico, you know, maybe using points and miles to fly for free and then staying in an all-inclusive, you know, think about that. You're actually going to save money by going on vacation.
Yeah.
Because you're not spending any money. And that's kind of a crazy concept. But Hyatt has all-inclusive resorts in Cancun, Puerto Vallarta, Cabo. So I was at the Hyatt Zilara. all-inclusive resort in Cancun, super easy to get to from MSP nonstop. And we stayed. It's super nice on the beach, easy to get to Cancun. So it's like Texas or Florida, really.
Yeah.
It's not really Mexico.
But still,
you can go for points and miles, and you can stay in all-inclusive, eat, drink for free using Hyatt points.
Hyatt points, everybody.
Yeah,
and
so
again,
getting a Hyatt, you know, credit card, you know, is an easy way to rack up those points super quickly.
Yeah, and again, part of the points thing, I'll tell you toward the end of the show.